So, who's taking on the test today? It's the titan of tattoo fixing, Sketch.
My personality, if I had to explain it, would be pretty artistic. Very creative and get kind of lost in my own thoughts quite a lot. Because I'm full of tattoos, most people look at me and just think, wow, like, it's going to be a nightmare.
And colossus of comedy, Russell Kane.
How would other people describe my personality? Mad, high energy, intense. Funny. I just love stuff like this. I love medicals, I love getting my blood pressure checked, I love scans. I like looking inside myself.
Well, brace yourself, Russell, because we're about to take a look inside you too. Deep inside. Very deep inside.
You can absolutely do the right thing by people all of the time.
You'll go mental if you believe that statement. You can't. You can certainly try to do the right thing, but you won't inevitably do the right thing by people all of the time. So it's absurd to believe that statement. Strongly disagree.
I think, yeah, you should. I think you should absolutely do the right thing by people all the time, because if you don't, and they don't, and the other person doesn't, and the other person doesn't, no one's going to do the right thing, and then we're going to end up completely destroying humanity.
I have a wide vocabulary.
I strongly agree with that, purely because when I started reading, I kept cards, and on each, every time I encountered a new word, I would write that word down. I collected 2,500 of those cards over my university career, and I would do those cards when I was on the toilet.
I can hardly spell, to be fair. Everyone's always on social media just writing all the spelling mistakes, and it pisses me off, if I'm fair. Like, it just literally comes up, that's how you spell there or there. My vocabulary as well is crap, so I can't even say the word properly, so I strongly disagree with that.
I'm not just like this, some sort of psychopath thinking I have a wide vocabulary. I actually set out to learn more words on purpose, using an index card system. Strongly agree. Next question. Boom.
I only do things when I am positive they are morally right.
No, I disagree with that. No, I don't think you can let off steam properly without being a bit immoral here. And in fact, I enjoy thinking sometimes, oh, that was a bit immoral. Wasn't it fun, darling? Again next week?
I mean, I grew up, obviously, a bit wayward when I was young. So, like, a lot of the things that my sort of gang when I was younger got up to, I would steer clear of some things, because obviously it's not going to benefit me and it's morally wrong what they're doing. So, yeah, I'll only do it if it is positive and I'm not going to end up in jail, mostly.
I am always forgetting where I put things.
Yeah, strongly agree. I wish there was another one at the end of the scale. It's weird, because my academic memory, if I set out to try and learn Italian before I go on holiday, I can remember weird quirks about verbs, but can I remember to bring my passport to the airport? No, so I don't even get to go to Italy. Strongly agree. Wouldn't even know where the passport was. Passaporte, in case you're wondering.
When my youngest daughter was born, I had her elder sister with me, and I went into the shop and I put them in a buggy bay and went to get Burger King, and I took my daughter out, but where my other daughter, just born, was only like 5 days old, I forgot I had her. So I left her in the buggy bay and went to get a burger, and then thought, oh my God. And I'd left her underneath the pushchair in the bottom in some little basket thing, but she was still there, so everything was fine.
Very pleased to hear it, Sketch.
I don't like being the centre of attention.
Strongly disagree. It's lucky for me I found the job that is the opposite of that statement. That's where I feel at home. There's definitely a sense of peace as soon as I'm on stage. A complete sense of being in exactly where I'm supposed to be that I never felt before in my life.
I don't like being in the centre of everything. If it's all about me, I hate it. So anxiety level just peaks so bad. So I strongly agree with that.
I get lost if people start talking about philosophy or complex ideas.
I would strongly disagree with that. In fact, I'm into all that sort of nerdy intellectual wanking. And if anything, I would be eager to show that I understood what they were talking about, just to show off I could follow them.
I strongly disagree with that because I actually believe that I'm very intelligent. Like, physiology and complex ideas, it's kind of my thing. Like, there's no way in the world that the Earth is round. Pretty sure of that, and I'll talk anyone's ear off for ages that we're on a flat plane.
I like using long words.
Do I like using long words? I love it. Strongly agree.
I try to think I know long words and they never come out well. I did learn a word the other day that was so long and I was like, I'm using that. No, can't remember it.
Test complete.
Yes, that was wicked.
Thank you for taking part.
I wonder how I've done on that.
Welcome, Bjarj.
I felt it very easy to speak to the TV than an actual person.
I like to think I've got all this brilliant insight into myself. So I hope that I'm proved wrong.
Their answers have been analysed by our psych tester, Lee, who's also compared them with thousands of others who've taken the test. It looks at six different personality traits. First up, do our celebrities come out as shy guys or show-offs?
You are a massive show-off.
No, that's a result. That's a result, really, because I've got quite a large mortgage. I was suspecting more underlying introversion to come through, because that's what people have said of me before.
Well, you think about it, you're conditioned by your environment. So you've been, in the last 10 years, you've been in show business. It's going to have some effect on some of your character traits.
I mean, if you think about it, a decade ago, I found it very difficult to even use the loo in the comedy club before I went on. I was so shy about using public toilets. Now it's like unthinkable. I fucking poo in a field before I do a festival gig. I've lost all of that. So maybe the introversion's gone with it.
Yeah.
Sketch's results suggest he's nowhere near as outgoing as Russell.
You're an introvert and you're quite shy, but you enjoy meeting other people and learning about them.
I do. I really like to meet new people and understand and hear their stories, but I need to feel comfortable.
Yeah.
If I don't feel comfortable, I'll be very shy. But if I feel comfortable around that person, I will open up and I will not be shy.
The test also looks at how conscientious our celebrities are. And it has Russell down as someone who likes to do things by the book.
A couple of things that came through for me is just how structured and organised you are. You talked about going on holiday.
I always take the Lonely Planet. If there's a walk, I want to do it. I research everything to the nth degree. When Lindsay was pregnant, it was me that researched different types of birth. I even did a conception chart. I knew the exact day she would be fertile. You know, I'm the organiser. Otherwise, she would just be, here, man, it happens when it happens. Namaste. Whereas I'm like, look, like, if we do it on this day, we'll be parents. You cool with that? Great. Right, up to the mating chamber. Bang. First go.
Compared to Russell, Sketch's results suggest he's a much more impulsive person.
You go with the flow, you're spontaneous, but it can also mean that you're a bit messy and you're quite forgetful.
Yes. I mean, if I wake up in the morning, in my head, all I have to do is take a dog for a walk, have a cup of tea, and get ready for bed. And then the phone would go, did it? And my missus would go, hope you remembered, cab's at 8:30, you're going to Birmingham this morning for this. I just follow the path that's laid, like, Whoa. Yeah, just as it goes.
Russell also comes out as a very inventive kind of chap.
So you're obviously very creative and you explore new ideas and enjoy new experiences. You know, this. It sounds like your brain is always on, you're always full of creative thoughts. Yeah. It's like, it's constant. What motivates you?
Ambition.
Yeah.
Ambition. So I can only give you the most recent example of something I've gone from scratch to fruition. And a YouTuber said to me, why is none of your generation doing these comedy blogs? So what on earth would be my motivation for trying it? Because a lot of people think that'll never work, and I love going, look, see, it did. What a buzz.
When it comes to new ideas, Sketch comes out as a little less creative than Russell.
You seem to be halfway between being cautious and being curious. And you talked about having lots of ideas, but then in another sense, you kind of suggested that you don't have ideas or they don't come to fruition and you weren't creative.
I think what I was trying to get across is I can have ideas, but it's like, if you crossed, like, an alligator with a zebra, it would look amazing. but it's not an idea that can actually come to fruition, is what I was trying to get across.
But when you think about your line of work, that could happen because that's what you do for a living. So you, somebody may want a tattoo, and you said yourself, you know, you started tattooing.
If you want it, you just ask.
Yeah.
Well, you said
sounds quite interesting, actually. And you said you start tattoos and you sometimes don't know what they're going to end up looking like.
100%, yeah.
Now, that, to me, describes someone who's massively imaginative and creative. Yeah. So I don't know if you're doubting yourself there a little bit too much.
Yeah, maybe.
Out of our six personality traits, Sketch's standout results suggest he's quite an introverted chap, that he's impulsive and likes to go with the flow, and that he has plenty of ideas, but can sometimes find it difficult to bring them to fruition. Compared to Sketch and all the others who've taken the test, Russell is extremely outgoing and feels happy when he's the centre of attention. And unlike Sketch, he prefers to be highly organised and efficient. He's also very imaginative and uses his energy and ambition to bring his ideas to life. Now that the test is over, what do our celebs think about their results?
I think Lee done an amazing job.
I found the experience invigorating, enlightening, pleasurable. It tickled my intellectual curiosity. I'm just nosy about myself as I am about other people, so I enjoyed it on that level.
I'm going to walk out of here with a smile, and hopefully I'm going to give him a crocodile tattoo, half zebra, half crocodile.